Hello and welcome to the Akeo Tech channel, where business and technology go hand in hand. Today, Akeo has brought SAM, or Shared Asset Management Platform, for you. This is a proof of concept created by Akeo based on the Hyperledger Fabric Blockchain. Since Hyperledger is a promising technology, Akeo has created a practical use case to see for itself how it can improve the performance and reliability of blockchain. With Hyperledger, IBM and Linux Foundation wish to spread the word that blockchain as a technology is capable of supporting global business transactions. These are the transactions which are happening on the day-to-day basis in sectors like technology, finance, and supply chain. Hyperledger Fabric Blockchain integrates independent open protocols and standards for use-specific modules, which make it easy for any business to adopt and build projects on it. Now, many business setups have assets and capabilities that cost millions of dollars. More often than less, these are not put to use on a regular basis. The reasons may vary from demand fluctuations to business setups where subcontractors are involved. This is where SAM, or Shared Asset Management Platform, comes into the picture. SAM is a product exchange platform where a manufacturer can list assets which can be used as shared resources. Businesses, on the other hand, can come and ask the manufacturer to use these assets. All these transactions will be recorded on the blockchain. And why is it so? Well, because being an immutable ledger, blockchain cannot be altered. Once promised, a manufacturer needs to make available the product on the set price and on the given day. Now let's begin the tour to see how SAM works. Now, using this pop-up card, create your profile. Enter your name. And your email ID. And select your role. You can select your role as a manufacturer or company. As a manufacturer, you can put up assets for sharing with other businesses. And as a company, you may place a request to use these assets on sharing basis. Select the role suited for you. For now, let's select the manufacturer role. And submit. Follow the same procedure to create a company profile. However, do remember, in case you wish to use SAM for both the roles, you need to use different Gmail accounts. After logging in, we will come to the View Assets tab. As a manufacturer, we can see the list of assets that have been put up for sharing purpose. We can also list new assets from this tab. To add a new asset, click on the Add New button on the top right corner of the website. A pop-up window will appear where we have to fill in the details like the title of the asset, type of the asset, description of the asset, and the price. And then select yes or no depending on the availability of the asset. And lastly, click on the submit button. This new asset will be visible in the asset list offered by you. This was the manufacturer's view. Now, let's also look at how the dashboard looks from a company's view. From the company's profile, you will be able to see the asset which is being shared by the manufacturer. If you as a company want to use any asset, then you can place a request with the manufacturer to use it. If the manufacturer accepts the request, then that asset will be shared with you. Next is the request status tab. In the request status tab for a company, the status of all the assets requested for sharing will be shown. The request ID, the device ID, the owner ID, and the status columns are shown. If the request is accepted, then approved will come in the status column, else pending will show in the status. For example, let us go back on the View Assets tab and request to use this asset. Now the status in the Request Status tab will show as pending. Let's see the manufacturer's view. The Request Status tab will have a new entry for the requested asset with the status as pending. If we click Accept in the Action column, then the status here will change to Approved. We can verify the same in the company's view as well. Here also the status of the Requested tab is now shown as Approved. This is where the concept of Hyperledger Fabric Blockchain comes into picture. Now that the manufacturer has approved the company's request to use an asset, this transaction has been recorded on the blockchain. Now the record details, like the agreed price and date of commencement of use, cannot be altered by the manufacturer under any circumstances. Next in the company view is the Active Status tab. This tab is only present in the company view as this gives us a list of all the assets which are approved by the manufacturer's side and are in the active state now. Next is the Transactions tab. This shows us a list of all the transactions that have taken place so far. It is same both for the company and the manufacturer view. It contains all the details of every transaction, that is transaction ID, type of transaction, timestamp, and to know more details, one can click on the View More button under the Action tab. Once you're done, simply click on the Logout button to end your session. Blockchain might seem as a really complicated technology, and in many ways it is. But remember that blockchain, and in this case Hyperledger Fabric, is just a database. In other words, all transactions are stored in a database that is automatically updated on all the nodes running the blockchain instantly. If something like this should have been done with a normal database, you had to set up a complicated database cluster. Well, that's it from the Akeo Tech team. Please feel free to start a discussion with us in the comments section. Are you interested in knowing more about how blockchain is being used today and what problems businesses are solving using this technology? Well, then head on over to akeo.tech where you can download for free your industry-specific ebook. We hope you're enjoying the content here on the Akeo Tech channel. Subscribe, like this video, and help us to spread this information and assist us in global blockchain adoption. Thank you for watching. We will keep bringing you more information, updates, and use cases of disruptive technologies and how they're changing our lives. If you have any suggestions or questions, please reach out to us on any of our platforms. Keep watching this space for more. Goodbye.